Welcome everyone, and in today's video I'm going to be doing my May TBR. Sorry for being so kind of MIA recently. If you watched my last video, you would know that I have been very sick. It hasn't been COVID. It's kind of been this weird kind of flu, but like every time I take a COVID test, it's been negative. I don't know. Anyway, so I've been quite sick. As you can tell, I'm still kind of on the mend by the way my voice is and things, but I'm slowly on the mend, so I feel like I'm in, you know, the right headspace and everything to kind of be able to film today. And, you know, I kind of lost my creative edge, not just with BookTube, but with kind of everything. I kind of have lost my creative edge. I kind of fell into a bit of a life slump, but I'm slowly pulling myself out of it, and I have so many video ideas coming up. Like, I was in bed the other night and I thought of a video idea when I was supposed to be sleeping, because like that basically sums up my life. So I'm super excited. So yes, thank you guys for being so patient with me while I've kind of been MIA, and let's jump on over into May. May is a very exciting month for me. It is actually my birthday month, so my birthday is May 23rd. I will be turning 24 years old, which to me is crazy. I'm feeling kind of a little bit old now. I don't know why, 24 for some reason, it's just kind of hit me. So we're gonna get into the books that I'm planning on reading over the month of May. I have 5 books on this TBR like I normally do, and they're kind of a mixture of everything because I fell into a romance slump. You guys will find out why, but I fell into a bit of like a romance slump, but we've got a good mixture and I'm very happy with this. So, the book on this TBR is a romance called Beatrice by Emily Henry. This is everywhere, this book, on BookTube, on BookTok, it's everywhere. The synopsis says, January is a hopeless romantic who narrates her life like she's the lead in a blockbuster movie, Icon. Gus is a serious literary type and thinks true love is a fairy tale. But January and Gus have more in common than they think. They're both broke. I'm feeling very called out by this right now. They have crippling writer's block and they need to write bestsellers before summer ends. The result? The bet to swap genres and see who gets published first. The risk? In telling each other's stories, their worlds might be changed entirely. So this is what Beach Read is about. I am probably the only person on the planet at this point that has not read an Emily Henry book. So I'm definitely jumping onto the Emily Henry bandwagon. I have got another one of her books. I think it's You and Me on Vacation, which I swear had a different title, or it does have a different title, but I think it depends on what country you're in. And I know her other one, Book Lovers, has just come out, which I haven't pre-ordered yet, but like, I'm going book shopping for my birthday, so I'm hoping my local bookstore has it, and I'm so excited. Anyway, Beach Read. So yes, this one is a romance book. Emily Henry is very well known for her romances. I am in a bit of a romance slump at the moment, so I'm not going to delve into this anytime soon, but I do want to read it over May. It's not that long either, so I don't think it will take me very long to get through. This one I'm actually very excited for, because obviously it's about writers, it will have books in it, and it looks like it's kind of like, you know, angsty, and hopefully it's got a little bit of a slow burn, so I'm very excited for that one. And then this next one is the second book in a series, and it is Jade War by Fonda Lee. Oh god, please excuse it, you can't even see that. That is disgusting. Yes, so Jade War, which is the second one in the Greenbone saga. I read Jade City last year, really enjoyed my time with it. It was so good. It is essentially about gangs in like Shanghai, and it kind of deals with more than that. As Fonda Lee did some things that I did not expect in that book, and I don't know why I've been putting off reading the other ones. I have all of them, obviously, as you can see right there. I have them all, but for some reason just haven't delved into them. Sorry, I'm trying to make this so you can actually see the title, but like, this lighting is disgusting. Anyway, so, but yes, I'm definitely excited to delve into this one and see what she decides to do next, because let me tell you, she took me on a roller coaster with her first book, and I'm like, what more could you do? And I've heard that the series only gets better and better and more crazier, and I'm like, girl, and I'm like, Fonda Lee, what more could you do? I mean, I'm kind of scared, a little bit. So, yes, so I'm not going to delve much into obviously Jade War is about, but again, very excited. I am worried it's going to suffer from second book syndrome, like most of them do, but we'll see, we'll see. Then we have a book that basically everyone and their mother has read, and naturally I haven't because I'm behind on the bandwagon for everything. It's A House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune. I know that this is like an adult book. Everyone loves it. Everyone has given it 5 stars. I've heard it's got quite funny elements And yes, it is also an like kind of an adult fantasy book. I honestly like, yeah, I know that it is about this, I know that it's about this social worker and he has to go to like this house, but it's not like, but he has to go to like this orphanage. It's not like a typical orphanage. It's an orphanage for kids with kind of who are extraordinary. That sounds so exciting. I'm really excited for this. Again, another one that's not too long. So I'm really excited about this one. I think that this one is honestly going to be my next read. I think I kind of just need something a bit light, a bit kind of something that might be funny and something that everyone has kind of read and enjoyed. So I'm thinking that this one's going to be next. And we have one of my current reads, because I'm filming this on like the 12th of May, because that just about sums me up. And that is The Kingdom of Copper by S.A. Chakraborty, which is another fantasy series. It is in the City of Brass series. Why am I forgetting these things? In the City of Brass series, this one is the second one, so I'm not going to delve too much into it. I'm actually listening to this as an audiobook. It is so good. The audiobooks are so good. I'm flying through the audiobook and I highly, highly recommend it. I'm loving it. It's so good. Not suffering from second book syndrome, and I'm very excited to continue on with the third one. And last, but certainly not least, and another one of my current reads that kind of rhymed, Only a Monster by Vanessa Len. So this one is, again, another fantasy book. This one I would kind of say it's an urban fantasy. So in this one, we follow a character called Joan. She finds out that she is actually a monster, and then she kind of meets up with these other monsters, and she's trying to navigate this world, as she has not been told that she was a monster beforehand. So she's kind of trying to navigate this new world while trying to hide from their foe, which is the hero of the story. And it's got time travel elements in it. It's got kind of, you know, enemies to lovers. It's got kind of fighting families, different families. You know, the powers are definitely very interesting, very interesting magic system kind of in here. So, and I like how we follow it from Joan, how she's supposed to be the villain, but then we kind of see that maybe she's not. And anyway, so it's good. I'm enjoying my time. Again, another one that's not too thick. From what I'm seeing, it's not that hard to read. One of the ones that you can kind of fly through a little bit, because the writing's not too complex or anything. So I'm interested to see where it goes from here and how Vanessa Len decides to wrap it all up. Those are the 5 books on my TBR. Some, as you can see, I've got a lot of fantasy because I kind of need to break up the romance. One of them is quite thick. Well, actually, 2 of them are quite thick. The rest aren't too bad. I'm very excited for this TBR. I'm very excited for all the books on this TBR. So let me know down in the comments below, what is a book on your May TBR? Also, if you have not, go follow me over on my social medias. My Instagram is on the _ pages and my TikTok is also on the _ pages. In case you want to see more content from me and more books that you might not see from, that you may not see from me on here. So yes, thank you guys so much for watching. Happy reading, and I'll see you soon for a new video. Bye.